Hi guys, Greg here and welcome back to my channel SITENG, where you're gonna find all you need to know about work and the life of a civil engineer. And today's video, guys, gonna be a little bit update on my SITENG project here. You can see that job behind me. If you watched me before, you know what it is here. If not, just guys, come back to this video. You're gonna see how it all went up from the ground works here, cap and beam, and Reddington's doing the frames now. But I decided to do that video as this is the last day here on my site. I just came back from holiday and picking my stuff here. You can see my motorbike here. You see actually the tripod here, and I don't know how I'm gonna take it on my bike, but I'm gonna sort something out, engineer in mind. And then guys, the big news is I'm going to the biggest job in Europe, Hinkley Point. So if you're not subscribed yet to this channel, just do so guys, turn the bell on, as there's gonna be the interesting videos coming. And this, all that side behind me, that's gonna be just a baby side comparing to that one. It's the biggest job, it's more than 50 cranes, tower cranes, I think the biggest crane there as well. So that's where we wanna be guys. That's the job every engineer wants to be on, the one of the big jobs like I showed you before in the city of London. But I think the Hinkley Point is even greater than the biggest project here in London, as this is loads of stuff, interesting stuff, cutting edge technology in terms of engineering guys. So yeah, I'm gonna show you quickly how the Hinkley Point looks. So I'm gonna give you the little bit. So let's have a look at guys, and you're gonna find everything on this channel. So guys, I'm here now and Hinkley campus, bye bye London. I don't know when I'm gonna see you again. But you can see behind me, there's a job there. You can see the big car, all these cranes here guys. I'm gonna show you in a minute the video which is gonna show you better all that job here. But that's the campus I'm staying here. You see all these blocks here. We got a big canteen there with a pub with everything. And behind me as well, you can see you can play football here. We got tennis court as well. And this campus is a Hinkley one, it's closer to the job. And there's a other one when I stayed actually one night when I get my induction here at the Sedgemoor campus, the bigger one, loads of people staying there as well. But if you guys like to know more about these things here, how this job is looking, as this is crazy, you actually got bus stops there as well. It looks like a big bus stops inside the bus, running around the job from the place to the place, from office to office and to the job. So if you want to know a little bit more about these things, let me know in the comments guys, and I'm definitely do like one video covering all this stuff. But let me show you this job from the better perspective now anyway. So guys, time for better perspective here, or we're gonna fly over the job here. And yeah, that's the reactor building. When I'm gonna be actually working as a section engineer here, I already met my crew, which is great. And what is great thing about this job as well is loads of people here guys from all over the world. I'm working from a section engineer from Libya. I met a great lady, she was dreaming about this job and she got here, Lala from Morocco. By the way, Lala, if you watch this, leave the comment. And guys, loads of people, as I said, South Africa, Romania, all Europe, and loads of French people. As the company I'm going to be working is the Bailor, which is a joint venture between Langaruk and Bouygues Travaux Publics. So as you can imagine, there's two great big companies. And the good thing about this job's already running around 5 years, but this job going to be running for another few years. So actually, if you're thinking about joining this project, there's still opportunity guys. And even if you're starting your career, or even if you're just thinking about starting your career, there's still loads of time to learn, and then you can join us here in the year or two as a site engineer, as a setting out engineer, or whatever really you want to do. So that's the great thing about it. I'm going to show you now the next video. So that tour guys is update from September here. We are now in the beginning of November. Not many things changes to be honest, but yeah, let's listen to the man.
Latest edition of the Hinkley Point C virtual tour. Today we're going to concentrate on Unit 1 of the Hinkley Point C. We're going to go to the nuclear islands, over to the galleries, and then we're going to go to the conventional island and the pump house. So let's go. Welcome to the nuclear island. This is what we call the HR building. So this is housed the steam generators and the actual reactor pressure vessel itself.
So this man gonna enter now internal structure of the reactor guys, but I just want to stop here, as you can see this old liner, that steel structure here. I'm gonna be actually working outside of it, doing the two big walls here. Very challenging project really. And yeah, let's listen to the man, let's have a look inside.
I'm gonna take you inside now and show the progress we've made to date and some of the challenges that we've got to achieve before the end of 2021. So follow me. So we're now entering the HR building here on Hinkley Point C Unit 1. achieve the 1.5 meter slab, which is actually 10 meters up in the reactor internal structures, is now complete. Beneath me is around 10 meters of different rooms, including the core catcher, the big IWRST pool, and a labyrinth of other rooms that will support services here in the reactor building. What you see behind is where the reactor will actually sit. So this is where the fission process will actually create the heat, which will then be transferred to the four steam generators that will be housed in this building. And then the steam that's created from them steam generators will go over to the turbine hall. Above me, you can start to see we're getting higher and higher and towards the top of ring one. We're planning at the moment, ring two is in the final completion of painting, and then we'll lower that on to the ring one in December of this year. So if I reflect on the challenge to dome lift, what you can see in here is what we call the reactor internal structures. So good progress, 1.5 meter slab complete, 5.15 meter slab done by the end of the year. We'll then continue upwards, and the key challenge for early in 2022 is to fit what we call the reactor pools. So these are huge pools that eventually hold the reactor pressure vessel and allow us to fuel and defuel the reactor. The next challenge outside is to do 11 lifts of concrete to cover up these steel liners that you can see here.
All right, just stop for a minute. So that's lifts, 11 lifts. That's going to be where I'm going to be working, actually, guys. And I can tell you already now, going to be big pressure on us as we nearly now in 2022. And they want to put that dome.
Liner ring two is all but complete and be ready to lift on in December. We're now doing the polar crane brackets in France, and they will be fitted to ring three, which will be fitted around May time of next year. And then finally, the dome, which is in really good shape to be lifted in at the end of 2022. Okay, over to the galleries, which we're going to visit next.
Okay, guys, I'm not going to be showing you the galleries. I just want to show you where I'm going to be working now. And obviously, if you like this video, guys, let me know. I'm going to try to do some updates here. I'm going to try also to show you how I'm going to, how I actually live, how the day looks here, living in the campus and going to the job, from the job, and on the job. Just guys, please, if you like it, don't forget to leave the thumbs up. Leave some comments below what you want to see here. If you got any questions, as always, guys, I'm going to answer as soon as I can. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, as this helps to grow our community here. And the great thing about it, I already met a few engineers who told me here that this channel helped them a lot when they were starting their career, when they were looking for information for setting out. That was great to hear for me, guys. I think that was the best feeling I had since I started my channel here, that there are people actually who are grateful for this, for what I'm doing and appreciating this. But guys, as I said, just leave the thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe, and follow my LinkedIn page as well, where you're going to find soon more and more information. So thank you again for watching, and see you next time.